Water? You guys doing all the way down there? It's time to talk about today's ball du jour, the newest ball in my collection. I'm very, very excited to start using it. It is a density ball. It's definitely floating. The water in the aquarium has a temperature, and that temperature is about 22.5 right now. But I'm about to change that by pouring in a big old pot of steaming hot water. Pour it in like this. I don't want the currents to affect the ball. There's a liter of steaming hot water and, oh, bye-bye, Bali. Clunk. The temperature will continuously change as the water mixes and its temperature changes, but it's clearly gotten warmer, and the ball has clearly sunk because of that. That's because a density ball is precisely made to have a density that is less than cool water, but more than warm water. Cool and warm, I'm not saying hot and cold, because we didn't change the temperature of the water in here that much, but that's all it took for the buoyant effect on this ball to be altered enough that it would sink, or that it would, in fact, let's make it float right now. I've got, I wanted to get big ice packs, but someone forgot to put those in the freezer. So instead, we're gonna use these bags of frozen fruit that belong to Jake. He's not in the office today, so just don't tell him that I got them all wet with my ball. But these are extremely cold. These are frozen, and they should drop the temperature of the water in the aquarium. And as that water chills down, it becomes denser. And the denser the water is, the stronger the buoyant force it exerts on the density ball will be, and the ball should float again. I'm gonna put one more frozen juice in. Water takes a lot of time to cool and to warm, unless you use an enormous amount of energy. So this isn't the fastest experiment in the world, but watch that temperature gauge. It should start dropping as we chill the water. So objects float or sink based on the ratio between their weight force and the buoyant force the fluid that they're in exerts on them. A buoyant force comes from the fact that water further down in the aquarium has a higher pressure because of the weight of all the water above it. So if the pressure, the actual oomph molecules have crashing into you at the bottom, is stronger than at the top, well, that means you're gonna be pushed up. All of us are pushed up. We're even pushed up by the fact that air pressure is greater down at our feet. But if that push up, if that buoyant force up is stronger than your weight force down, you'll float. But by raising the temperature of the water in this aquarium, by pouring in that almost boiling water, we were able to make the water less dense. That dropped its buoyant force and it was no longer able to support the density ball, so the ball fell. But if we cool the water down, it should become more dense. Its buoyant force on the ball should increase and the ball should float up. It's just a matter of time. These frozen juice bags are not doing the job very quick. Let's see, what temperature are we at now? 23.6. And this water began at 22.5, right? So we've got more than a degree to go. But we're gonna sit here and we're gonna watch this happen in real time, whether you like it or not. Just kidding, we'll do a time lapse. So we're getting there. Our temperature is now 22.6, and 22.5 is where we were when it was floating on the top. Now, obviously our thermometer is sampling the water temperature over here, but the ball's over there. But we have proven that these frozen bags of fruit or ice, I don't even know, they don't belong to me, but I still do what I want with them. We've proven that they're very cold and they're lowering. I feel like I should maybe get a little phone video of it finally surfacing. Hey everyone, say hi. We're spending our Monday watching balls move. Yeah, let's just take these out. Ugh. This is a fresh egg. We just bought these today. They are totally ready to be eaten. Well, let me put one in water and we'll see if it sinks or floats. Okay, it sinks. The buoyant force the water puts on it isn't enough to lift up its weight force. But we're not done, because way back in January, so we're talking like almost 5 months ago, we had some eggs that were expired, and I said, let's keep them. And I wrote, Michaels, oh, these are bad eggs. These have been bad for a long time, but take a look. I'll pull one out here. Ugh. Doesn't look that bad. If you didn't have a functioning nose, you might go ahead and eat this. So how do you know if an egg is bad or not? Well, put it in water. If it's a good egg, it'll probably sink, but if it's a bad egg, it'll probably float. Why would that be? Why has the density of the rotten egg changed? Here's another rotten egg. Here's another rotten egg. And let's put in some fresh eggs. We're not gonna mix up the two because the good ones sink and the bad ones float. They're different colors, but the color isn't affecting the buoyancy. So another good egg, and let's put in two more bad ones. I mean, may as well put these to use. anyway, what happens is that the egg shell is not completely airtight. And so the fluids that are inside the eggs, oh, in fact, I don't know if you guys can see this, but let me grab my phone, there's little air bubbles coming up out of one of the fresh eggs, because there's gas inside the egg, and there's liquid as well, obviously, and that liquid can evaporate, and then it can come out of holes in the egg. So yeah, there's air coming out of the egg, because egg shells are not airtight, and that's not a bad thing that I'm seeing air come out, that's literally how they work. But anyway, those gases can leak out of an egg over time, and the liquid in an egg will evaporate, and the air comes out, so the total mass inside the egg goes down, but its size doesn't change, so its density goes down, which means as it gets older and older, it starts to float. So there you go. Density eggs, density balls, and as always, thanks for watching. Let me be the one. Let me be the one. Let me be.